Today, we're going to be taking you on a new home tour in one of the most unique communities available in Richmond, Virginia, Rocket's Landing. We've been living in Richmond for the past 4 years in a variety of apartments, moving all the way from the outskirts of the city, more towards downtown. And right now, we're pretty central. We're only a few blocks away. We really like the area, and we think we'll be staying here for a while. However, in the apartments that we've been living in for the past couple of years, all of them have had kind of a few limitations, whether it's space, parking, or some other inconveniences that we just kind of want to try to avoid as we become more situated and decide to live in the city for a longer period of time. Throughout this video, we're going to be telling you how we decided on the Rocket's Landing community, our home floor plan, and some of the other pros and cons of moving into that area. So we'll be taking one of these buses from the stop down the road. And as we're recording this, the Rocket's Landing community is actually finishing up development. So we were actually able to secure one of the last units in that community before they were all sold out. So we're pretty excited about that. Me and I did have a lot of must-haves for our first home. And while this was definitely a more expensive home than we originally were looking for, we felt just with the investment opportunity of this location, the uniqueness of it, as well as some of the main features that it had, and checking off a lot of the things that we wanted compared to other communities, it was definitely worth the additional investment required initially with this. Over the next few months, between it finishing up its building stage and us actually moving in, we'll show you moving into our very first home that we can call our own.
And here we are, it's just two stops from downtown Shaco Bottom to Rocket's Landing. It's about just a mile, 6 minute drive, less than half an hour to walk here. We've walked to the new home from our apartment and back. It's actually a really great area just to walk around in. There's the Capitol Trail that goes all the way from Williamsburg. And right across from the bus stop where the community kind of begins, we have Contra Public, another restaurant, and then the Boathouse right here. And another really amazing thing, besides the incredible view of the water and the entire James River behind us, we have a lot of other good amenities, so let's go check them out. We're walking down here towards the boat landing, the Capitol Trail, and the dock. We have all the amazing things that comes with being by the water. We're gonna start down by the pier where the fishermen are. Check that out, all the amenities down there, because there are several, and then go further down the trail and show you even more of what our community will have.
Before deciding on this community, we were actually pretty set on moving to New York City. Me, I was finding a lot of jobs over there. I was getting some opportunities over there as well. I really like the big city lifestyle and being able to just do a wide variety of activities and just the uniqueness of it. And while Richmond does have some of that, there isn't that constant level of activity that you get in New York City. At the same time, we knew that if we were going to live here, we wanted to stay relatively close to downtown because that is where a lot of the activities that we still do are. And with that, you can see, again, just the proximity to the city as well as the views that you get. And even being a bit further out from the city and you don't have much of that hustle and bustle that you would get being downtown like we currently are with our apartment. Over here, it has its own lifestyle and own set of activities going on. You have all the fishermen down there on the pier. Whoa! As well as, of course, all the boaters out there. And over here, we actually have a volleyball court.
There has been several times where Rocket's Landing actually held the Virginia State Volleyball Professional Tournament. It was great to just come out here and see people trying really hard who are the best at what they do, and it's right here. That's not even mentioning all the holiday stuff that goes on for the 4th of July, which you guys should get to see in one of our housewarming videos. This place has the Rockets Red Glare 4th of July fireworks, where they have a fireworks boat that comes out and launches a bunch of fireworks, and we get to see it right from our house. And as we pass Contra Public, these are condos and further downtown homes, and these were the first residences to be built in this area.
They are kind of one of a kind in terms of how they look from the outside. You're not really actually going to see any other homes in the community that look quite like this. And because of their location, they have unobstructed views of the river. There's not going to be any new construction in front of them, unlike some of the other developments that you see down the river that we're going to be exploring in just a bit. Throughout our walk here, you'll see a couple signs that say for lease. We have a couple other developments that are coming up in the area, whether it's going to be a restaurant or some other shops and mini marts that we'll actually tour in just a bit. It's actually cool to see that this community is continuing to grow even though the residential part of it has stopped. On my left-hand side here, we do have the dog park, which is exclusive to community members. And further down, we have some of the cooler amenities, in my opinion. You've got our hot tub, one of our pools, as well as, I think the gym is in there too. Behind us, we do have some garden plots, which are part of your property, depending on some of the homes over here. So even though you don't actually get a yard, it is cool that some of these homes do have the ability to still upkeep a garden, have some vegetables and some other cool flowers there as well.
One thing that was not on our wish list for a new home was any yard work whatsoever. We don't have a yard, we don't have one of the garden plots, but we do have a rooftop patio. That works just fine for me. All of my plants are in planters. Currently, most of them are dead because I do not have a green thumb, but I'm going to continue to try my best. And if that works out, maybe I'll have a tiny little vegetable patch on our rooftop deck. Some of the last amenities that we can take a look at before we reach just fully residential area is the second pool. So there's two pools and a hot tub. And despite having all of these amenities, the HOA is under $200, which was something else that we found was really amazing. To the right here, we have a really old building. I think it used to be some type of steel manufacturing building. Currently it's for lease, and I've heard that somebody is thinking about taking that on and making another restaurant out of it. And to my left, we actually have our first set of rental residences here with the East 51 apartments, and it has all garage parking underneath, which is another great thing about this area and something that's extremely hard to come by in the city. One thing with these apartments, they are relatively new, they are luxury apartments, and they bring a diversity of lifestyles, ages, and people to this area that I don't think were there before this construction.
This is actually the first of the HH Hunts that's actually on the river and has a river view. There are a couple of them that actually started further in development back behind these apartments and condos there. There are two floor plans that HH Hunt makes. We have the Cameron, which is identified by the balcony on the front there, and then you have the Drake. They're both essentially the same with the exception of the front balcony. Because of its balcony, the Cameron does have overall a little less square footage compared to the Drake, so it's really down to preference. Do you think you'll be using a lot of that outdoor area on your main living area, which has your kitchen and your living room? In our opinion, we thought we would, and we wanted to benefit from having that outdoor area on the front there without the need to go to the rooftop deck, which all these units do have. Further down here, we do have the start of Stanley Martin's construction there. And you'll notice that they are actually four floors instead of the three that we see here with the HH Hunt. The biggest difference between the two communities is that HH Hunt's homes are actually townhomes. So your entire three floors are just for you. The Stanley Martins are actually considered condos. You're actually sharing the building with another person. Below you or above you, you're gonna have another unit. The one thing that we really didn't like about those floor plans when we toured some of the resale ones is for the larger floor plans, which we needed, you had to climb up two sets of stairs before you actually got to the main living area of your own. I just wanna show the resale homes that are available here. This is one of the only ones available right now at the time of filming this. All the other ones have sold within days, and this one is probably gonna be off the market in a couple days as well. And as you enter the new construction lots, of course, you're going to be dealing with a lot of the construction vehicles that are coming by, all the construction workers, some of the noise. So that is going to be a little bit of a downside in terms of moving back there into the area that we actually have purchased our home. However, all these are due to wrap up around the same time, so it's not going to be too bad for too long. But one thing I did want to mention, as we are by the Stanley Martins, there are two doors, again, because you're sharing that main entrance with someone else, because half of the building is going to be for your unit and half is going to be for the other person that's either living above or below you. Coming up the hill, we do have one other apartment building. Like Mia was saying, it gives you a wider variety of ages and demographics that are living here. Below it, you do also have some spaces that are available for lease, which we're anticipating either being stores or little mini marts as well. I won't exactly call that the entrance, but there is a nice sign above that awning there where you actually have the cross between the condos and some of the other condo units on the right-hand side, where it just says Rockets Landing. It's really cool. And on the other side, going all the way to the bottom again, is the river. And on the actual compass itself, we have some of the history of the area. And it's cool to have all of this just encompassed in one location. But one of the other interesting things, and what we were just talking about a little bit earlier, is the actual sundry little market area that recently opened up, and they're called Market Cafe. So we're gonna check them out really quickly.
And everybody's been so nice here and so welcoming. Like we said, before this shop even opened, they said, come in, come check us out. We'll be open in a couple days. We can't wait to see you. and everybody we've walked past when we were first looking at the home said hello. They pick up after their animals. They're so kind, and that's another reason why I really wanted to choose this area, because it just felt so welcoming and warm and safe and relaxing. I love it so much. It kind of feels like you're on a vacation all the time.
It's actually kind of unique how they built out the Rockets Landing community. They kind of started from each end and worked their way towards the middle. So right here was one of the final areas that they're building, completely new construction. Another main difference between the Hunts and the Stanley Martins is that these only have single car garages, because again, you are sharing one other side with the other unit. With that first level of the Stanleys being completed over there and three more levels coming up, you can imagine with these Hunts over here, unfortunately, much of their views, if not all of it, with the exception of the rooftop deck, is probably going to be eliminated. They're not going to be able to see the river anymore. Sitting in front of the Stanley Martins, you can see the main differences in their final shape, construction, and look. Even though there is a bit of a difference between them, they complement each other pretty well in it. It doesn't feel too out of place like you would see in maybe some other communities. If we continue down this alley, this is how we get to some of the newer Hunts and how we get to our area as well. Having this passage open is what allowed us to have some actually decent views of the river, despite the fact that we're three rows back, or currently two, but will be three rows back. And the reason I mention that is because as these Stanleys continued down, unfortunately, they weren't smart enough to actually keep this area open. They've done a lot with these units in the past couple of weeks. It wasn't until a couple of days ago that they actually had some of the heavier machinery through here. These will be little grassy areas that aren't actually part of your home. Not an issue. The only thing that actually is part of your property are those little bushes over there. But that is one of the trade-offs for someone who is maybe coming from a bigger home or is used to the idea of having a yard. That's not something you're going to have with these homes.
So here we are. This is our little porch area. Like he mentioned, not sharing this with anyone else. So any decor we put here, it would be all ours. Now, of course, there's a lot of things missing. There's a lot of things under construction. This won't be done for another couple months. It's so cool to see the changes and how everything is getting built. There is still a lot of light coming in, even though it is very late in the day. It's about 6-ish. This is going to be a great place to put some entryway things, some shoe racks and coat hangers. This floor plan had the ability to have an optional enclosed office with a door in here. This is an optional addition upgrade to this type of floor plan. The base floor plan is no wall, no door, completely open. Or you can upgrade to having this enclosed in office / first floor bedroom area, whatever you'd like to make it. I think for us, it's going to be like my office / craft area. It has a closet, which is gonna be really difficult to get into because it has no handles yet, but lots of storage space in this place, which is something that was definitely on our wish list. Another thing I wanna point out is how much natural light we're now gonna have in this place. We have windows everywhere, and that's something that was really important for us to have in our home. So as we move out of this office and towards the garage, which is through here, you can see that as it's under construction, this has become kind of like a catch-all for some of the stuff that they're using. But it is that two-car garage space. It will have a workshop sink. It will have like a water hose attachment line. We have these little nooks back here that just give added storage space, give us a place to put things. Once we leave the garage, we do have a full bath here actually, which is kind of dark because we don't have electricity yet. To have a full bath on every other floor is pretty great. We have a full bath here, a half bath upstairs, two full baths on the third floor, and then the rooftop deck has a half bath. Really, really helpful. There's more storage space in this big closet here. Up the first set of stairs that are eventually going to be all hardwood, which is another thing we really wanted in the house, we will get to our kitchen, dining room, and living room area with this nice little landing that we can put some nice decor on and decorate it. And actually, this stuff has just come in. We haven't even seen it yet, so I'm super excited. This is the first time I'm looking at it. All of our cabinetry is starting to be put in. Our light fixtures are here. Our balcony rails are in. Everything looks so cool. So let's take a closer look. This will be our living room, even though it has some cabinetry in here right now. That's cool. It will have our fireplace with built-in cabinetry installed on each side of the wall. This really cool brick accent is great. And it will already come with hookups for a mounted TV, so that's really cool. So this will be our sink and our bar area. We'll be able to put our bar stools right up against here just for a small eat-in kitchen type area. That is so nice. I love the light fixtures. And then we have this little area that can be your little dining area. You can have a table and chairs. Yeah, I really want to make a reading nook. So I think part of this area might be that reading nook. I'm super excited about that. Not as excited as I am about the balcony. And even though the main road is like right there, it is kind of quiet and peaceful still here on the balcony, which is another reason that we did decide to choose this floor plan. And I just can't wait to like get some furniture out here and just read a book or relax, just hang out. As you can see, what he was talking about earlier with that footpath that goes out into the Stanley Martin construction, where you can currently see the water, and we're not sure how long that view will last, but we're enjoying it while it does. If I had to pick one small con about our kitchen area, it would be the size and the location of this pantry area. It is pretty small, and you do have to walk quite a ways from the food preparation area. But that's not really a problem at all because we have so much out there that this might just end up being a linen closet for this half bathroom, which is just construction stuff at the moment. And with the Drake, your kitchen is actually on the left side with no balcony, and that whole corner becomes part of your kitchen and the bathroom is in the middle. Now we're going to go up to what will also be another full set of hardwood stairs to the landing for the third floor and the bedrooms and the laundry room, which is another thing I really love about this floor plan with the Cameron and the Drake. The laundry room is right up here with the bedrooms, which is exactly where I think it should be. And we will go straight into the guest bedroom after that. It is on the right as you come up the stairs. It has a small walk-in closet and a full bathroom attached, and beautiful tall windows. Three of them brings lots of natural light in, and high ceilings make this feel really big and spacious. It's so bright, again, even at like 6:30 in the evening, and it's quiet. I think it's gonna be great. And now we get to the master, which is another huge space, very tall ceilings, another set of three windows, recessed lighting here, and it just feels so calm and so relaxing, and I love all the light. And it has two closets. Ooh, and our tile is in. That's new. So it has this large walk-in closet, not as large as some of the other homes that we looked at did have, but I think it makes up for it in actual space of the bedroom. And this could be another closet. It could be like a linen closet for this full master bath, which has a little room for its own toilet, which is really cool. This is new tile that was just put down. It will have a huge walk-in shower with a little seat area. It has one built-in shelf, which we're definitely gonna need more, but that's all right. There's still one floor left to take you on, and it's one of the best. Up here is the entrance to our rooftop deck that has the wet bar area. And while neither of us drink, it will be really great to host people with. Mini wine cooler here, there'll be a sink, but there's also a half bath. The sink, toilet, you don't have to leave the rooftop deck to use the bathroom, which I think is pretty great. The rooftop deck is so awesome. Right now it's a little messy because of all the construction, of course. This railing they just put in, we haven't seen that yet either. This is the smaller side, so we'll get to see. Hi neighbors! This is another place that we haven't quite decided what we're doing yet. The L shape of this gives us a lot of space for entertaining, for plants like I was talking about, and just look at the view. The one really awesome thing about the location of our home is that it's open on east and west. So we get sunrise and sunset. When a new building pops up in front of us, it will still be a bit lower and it won't obscure our horizon line. So that's really nice.
We'll be able to see the trees. We're probably gonna lose the water there with the buildings.
You can see the city skyline right in front of me. So we're thinking maybe some tables, chairs. I really want a hammock, something to lay out with, maybe a fire pit. My planting areas along this side. There's a water hose attachment right here, so I don't have to worry about how my plants may get the water. It's gonna be so incredible.
So that's been the tour of Rocket's Landing and our soon-to-be home. We're really excited to be sharing this journey with you. We have a lot coming up in terms of showing the progress inside this home, as well as sharing updates with the community, and of course, telling you our experience with our new home in this amazing area. So stay tuned for all that. Thanks again for tuning in, and until the next one,